Everybody, welcome on out to another video. My name is Ty. Thanks for clicking on this one and joining me. Super stoked for today's video. We had a brand new single drop from probably my most hyped album in years, Bruce Dickinson's new solo album, The Mandrake Project. Yes, the Bruce Dickinson. I already did a reaction to his last single that came out, The Afterglow of Ragnarok. Watch the video and react to the song. You can check that on the channel out right now if you'd like. I really dug that song. It made me more hyped for the album. The production on it was really good. I thought Bruce sounded well. Honestly, it made me more hyped for it than any of like modern Maiden albums, probably the last three or four albums, honestly. So yeah. This is a different side of Bruce that we don't get often, when he is able to flex his creative wings and kind of take control over everything, where he doesn't have to work within the confines of Iron Maiden and, you know, work with the other dominant personality in the band, Steve Harris. So I am excited for this song. Like I said, it dropped today. I have not heard a second of it. I have not watched the video. The song is called Rain on the Graves. And that's a really cool title. I think I did see a still shot from this on the Iron Maiden subreddit. So that's all I've seen. So I know nothing. I'm hoping for more of the same. I'm hoping for another really good mix. Yeah, I'm just I'm super excited for this album. It comes out in a few short months, and the amount of promotion and all the stuff that they're putting into it, like, it's building up that hype, and I love that. We don't get that often. I don't feel that way often. Like, you get older and you get jaded, and you just kind of like stop caring in a way. And like, I haven't been this excited for an album in a very long time. We'll buy it day one, that's for sure. So anyways, guys, let's get into it. Before I do, hit the like button, subscribe, shooting for 500 subs before the end of the year. So hopefully we can get there. Comment down below on this song. Are you super stoked for the album? Are you pessimistic about the album and not looking forward to it? Why not? Let me know. Sound off in the comments down below. So let's get into it. Bruce Dickinson's Rain on the Graves. You know, he's obviously going very story heavy with a lot of this stuff. So I'm digging it. Like, I'm digging the comic book idea, and he's even doing like cards and stuff. So, I mean, I already like the way this looks better than the other video. The gothic vibes. The other video had the CG mixed in with the live action stuff. So, Bruce acting. So that's always great. I mean, if anything, I always want Bruce Dickinson acting. That's what most people say. I'm curious to see how long this song actually is, because this video is nearly 8 minutes long. But obviously, we're about a minute in, so we have a minute of intro that obviously won't be on the record. So, I'll give him props for the production, and like, because these are really well shot and they look really good. So, massive props there. Like, I'm instantly digging the guitar tone again. Like, I feel like Roy Z and Bruce are kind of nailing that on this. Like, it's different enough from Maiden to necessitate this album's existence. We have, like, old Hellboy here. He's kind of in like a senjutsu like register here, kind of that lower tone. I dig it, like writing on the wall, like that's kind of the, where he sits on that song. So we'll see if it, like, when the chorus starts, if he gets into that typical Bruce register. Like, I dig the cheesiness, I dig the campiness. Like, I love B movie horror campiness, and that's what this is. And I dig the fact that he's having a lot of fun. Like, you can tell. Like, he's spreading his... There it is, yeah. So it's like he's spreading those creative wings again. Oh, we're actually getting band shots a little bit. That's cool. Will we actually see band members? Maybe? I don't think they've... I don't think he's really said who's, like, on the record yet. I don't know. I probably did. I missed it, though. This is a cool video. Oh, we're getting some stereo dynamics there. It's pretty cool. Kick drum. Faithless, he denied the truth that he had come to steal. To kneel before the poet, not the altar or the priest. Guitar. This is really cool. I actually seen band shots. The last video we didn't see. Well, only Bruce was in that video as far as, like, you know, band members. I'm going to commend this record so far. Like, Roy Z, the production on this is already light years ahead of any modern Maiden. It's mixed really well for a modern hard rock, metal-ish record, whatever genre you want to, just rock record. Most modern albums sound like garbage. And even this compressed through YouTube, like, I'm really digging the mix. Like, the guitars, you can hear the drums, the bass, everything is mixed really well. Bruce is mixed really well. He doesn't dominate the mix, which is nice, because Maiden, you kind of get like a weird muddiness on modern production. I'm not a big Kevin Shirley fan, and then, like, just kind of Steve dominates everything on modern Maiden mixes, which is fine. Like, I'm not bagging on Steve. Like, that's just kind of is what it is. But yeah, I'm really enjoying the mix on this song so far, and the mix on the previous single as well. Like, this is going to be a cool record, man. Yeah, so we are getting band shots. It's really cool. I'm assuming these people will play on the record. That's Roy Z there. So I don't know if this will also be his touring band. Good amount of keys in here too. It's cool. I love the campiness, man. Like, he's just having a blast with all of this. I guarantee it. Just the production, this, the whole show of this record and the promotion behind it. Like, you can tell he's putting a lot into this. It's a really catchy song. Okay, solo. And then you got the keys in the background. That's really nice. It's a good solo, too. It's catchy. Like, this isn't, like, blow you away, like, holy shit, but, like, it's... Like, to me, this song... This is better than anything that was on Zenjutsu. Like, I love Maiden. They're one of my all-time favorite bands. But, like, this is easily better than anything that was on Zenjutsu or Book of Souls. Definitely Final Frontier. Alright, well, we gotta have a little bit of bad CG. PS2 graphics. Got him. That laugh. Rain on the Graves. Cool song title. William Blake. What a cheesy video. Really cool, though. It's well shot. It looks good. Really cool to see the band in there. I'm digging the song. Honestly, probably like it more than the previous single. Production on it is really cool. Like, this solo part was really catchy. Are we done? Okay, we're getting into credits, so it's a cool logo. A musical horror short written by Bruce Dickinson. Rod Smallwood. Where's the cast? Yeah, Bruce, Tim Curry, yeah, Rosie. Okay, Dave Marino, Mysteria, Tanya O'Gallaghan, Gallahan. Either way, I'm digging it. The band sounds good. The production on it. This solo is really cool, really catchy. I dig the use of keys on this. Yeah, this is a really, it's going to be a really good album. And like I was saying before, like this is, it sounds enough like Maiden to where I'm pretty sure Maiden fans, diehard Maiden fans are just going to be really into it, but it's different enough to necessitate its existence. A lot of solo artists, you know, or solo bands, solo projects by guys from established bands, it just ends up sounding the same. And it's just like, well, why isn't this just the band? Whereas all of Bruce's albums have sounded different enough, and you can tell he's putting different influences into it that he can't necessarily put into Maiden, because you're in that band dynamic. And like I said, you're dealing with Steve, who's ultimately making a lot of the decisions on stuff anyway. And, yeah, I mean, Roy Z's light years better than Kevin Shirley. I'm digging their production. I'm super stoked for this album. I don't know about you guys, but I am very, very stoked for Bruce's new album, The Mandrake Project, which comes out, what, I think a few months? Like, it's May, I think? March or May? I think it's spring. Is there a date on here? On the app now. There's no, you can pre-order and pre-save now. He's on tour in 2024. Not doing any U.S. dates, as far as I'm aware, yet. I'm hoping we get some. That'll be really cool. But Maiden's coming back here next year, too. So I don't know if that's going to work out or not. So anyways, guys, if you dug the song, or if you didn't dig the song, leave a comment down below. Let me know your thoughts. Also, like the video, subscribe if you're into this type of stuff. If you like physical media, vinyls, you know, vinyl records, CDs, cassettes, we talk about a lot of that type of stuff here. We also do reactions and unboxings of stuff and just, you know, generally BSing about music. So if you want to join us, hit the sub button, all that good stuff. I've been Ty, you've been you, and I'll see you next time. Peace.